This channel and the HitboTC brand is intended for late teens and adults. Anyone under the age of 13 should not be watching my content. What's up, everyone? It's HitboTC here with my top tips for beginners getting back into Call of Duty franchise, with the latest version being Modern Warfare. These tips are pretty universal to all of the Call of Duty games, though, and if applied, will help you achieve a better kill-death ratio, and more importantly, that win-loss ratio as well. So with all that being said, let's do this. With each Call of Duty game, we see a variety of weapons come to the game depending on what era the game is focused on. We also see the introduction of new perks and bringing back some old favorites. That being said, it is your job to know the weapons, their damage, how many shots it takes to kill, and at what the best distances are for those weapons. Call of Duty Modern Warfare is no different. They have brought back a variety of classic weapons that we have enjoyed through the years, but they also have introduced some new weapons to the game, allowing for a variety of different styles of gameplay that match your playing style. Something to keep in mind here, though, is that any game update will most likely bring some type of changes to the weapons, so keeping an eye on those patch notes is very important. The devs have always liked to tweak and change things to help find a healthy balance to the game, so what may be the meta now won't be in the future updates, so make sure you're always staying informed. A great place to stay informed on this is the subreddit for Modern Warfare. I highly recommend you join up if you have not already. I've linked them down below in the description of this video. Anyways, on top of weapons, it is also very important to know the perks and the combination of perks that best fits your playing style. Everyone is going to be a bit different, and that is okay. But understanding all the perks and what they all do will help you know what to look out for and how to fight those enemies on the ground. I cannot stress the importance of this enough. In fact, if there's anything you take away from this video, it should be this point. Learning the maps can make all the difference, and honestly, this is something that only comes with time. When I say learning the maps, I'm meaning something beyond just the simple layout of the map too. I'm talking about learning common camping spots, where people tend to run at first. If you are up against good players, they tend to play and run certain ways and paths. If you are versus some noobs out there, they tend to do certain things as well. Having this knowledge only takes time, but understanding this is a technique you can develop. The more you play, the more you will learn the maps, but what I want you to take away from this point is, again, learning more than just the simple map. It is learning all the choke points, learning those common camper spots, best way to flank flags, kill zones you don't want to hang out in too long, etc. Each map will bring its own challenges, and each game type will bring its own as well. However, learning the map will be a universal thing you can apply across any game mode you play, and will help you be a better player and help your team with more wins. We've all seen the videos of a noob so focused down his scope that he has absolutely no idea that a gun is pointed at the back of his head. Situational awareness is keeping an ever watchful eye and ear on your surroundings. This means not getting so lost aiming down your scope that you are not paying attention to what's going on around you. This also means thinking ahead and beyond just what is happening right now. Teams that lose game modes like Ground War lose because they forget about the objectives that matter the most. If you want to camp out somewhere, that is fine, but camp out somewhere where you can defend the objective. Killing for killing's sake is pointless if you don't stay focused on your objectives. I cannot stress this point enough. Situational awareness is what will make or break you in this game and any first-person shooter. Being aware of what's happening, how much ammo you have, where your teammates last died, and what angle that got them killed, the list goes on and on. The only way to get better at this is to think and understand what is happening in the game until it becomes second nature for you. It is a skill that you have to develop and be intentional with. obviously, this is an important one as well. Having good communication with you and your team can mean victory or getting mocked by the other team for how bad you are. Either way, having good communication can let your team have a better chance of winning. Things like letting your squad know where you are going, working together toward a common goal or objective, letting your squad know where the enemy is, or even possibly a sniper. The best thing you can do for this is to find a squad and play with them. You start to understand how they play and how you play together. Communication between you and your squad will become second nature and you will dominate. One last thing I want to mention on this point though would be, don't just say stupid stuff into your microphone. Don't yell when you get killed. This is distracting. And just like good communication will help you succeed, bad communication will make you fail. While you are yelling about how you just got smoked, your teammate is trying to apply situational awareness and either trying to listen to where those footsteps are coming from or what angle that got you killed. And you are just sitting there crying. Well, it's time to suck it up, Buttercup, and help your team out by not having bad communication. So again, focus on that good communication and try to get that whining down to a minimal. This is a big one. I know you can play solo in any Call of Duty game, but one of the best tips I can give you is to find a regular squad to play with. If you want to dominate and win games, finding a squad that you play with regularly will be all the difference that you need. It also helps you to just have a good time in the game playing with your buddies. Sometimes the game isn't going your way, but being able to have a good laugh will help you keep calm and remember that at the end of the day, games are meant to be fun. Now, I know a lot of you guys out there don't have a squad and it's tough finding one. One of the best ways to do this is to get involved in a Discord community that fits you and the type of gaming you like to do. Now, I have a shameless plug here, but if you're looking for a family-friendly gaming community, you can join mine. It's a great community that focuses on making memories and building relationships with other like-minded gamers. I'll make sure to drop the Discord invite link in the description below and in the comments. Well, those are all the tips I have for you for now. I wanted to focus on the big picture stuff when it comes to tips for Call of Duties. These things that I covered, you will be able to apply to any game you play in the future. Thanks for watching, and if you like this video and want to see more, make sure to hit that like button. And if you never want to miss a new video, make sure to hit that subscribe button and click the notification bell. Thanks again for watching, guys, and I hope to see you out there.